Welcome to Dear SQL DBA, a podcast and YouTube show for SQL Server developers and database administrators. I'm Kendra Little from SQLWorkbooks.com. Today, we're talking about the death of SQL Server service packs. SQL Server is no longer going to have service packs for SQL Server 2017 and future versions. So service packs are going away, but for your existing older versions of SQL Server, you're still gonna have service packs just like before. This change is for SQL Server 2017, which just hit general availability, and future versions. We're still gonna get fixes for SQL Server. It's just that the support cycle isn't going to include service packs. And I actually think this is a great change, and I'm really glad. I will not miss service packs. I know that people are used to them. I know that it's a change, but I think that it's a really positive change. We will still have cumulative updates. And the old story for cumulative updates is that they used to be kind of confusing and weird. The old story, like years ago, when Microsoft released these bundles of fixes called cumulative updates for SQL Server, they had this little note on them that was like, you should only install this cumulative update if it fixes a problem that you have. We don't generally recommend applying these all the time. So this was kind of a weird thing because when you read the release notes for cumulative updates, you see that these fixes are for lots of different issues in the SQL Server. And a lot of times you read these issues for fixes and you say, well, we don't want to have that problem. I'm not sure that we've had that problem, but we certainly don't want to hit it. And used to, this would put you in kind of an odd situation because you would know that an issue is fixed by a cumulative update. But the advice on the cumulative update was like, well, you know, you shouldn't install this unless it really fixes something for you. Things could go wrong. So you'd want to be proactive and install the cumulative update because, hey, say you do hit the problem and you're like, oh, well, I happen to know that's fixed by a patch. Well, shouldn't you have applied the patch to prevent it, right? Things did change for cumulative updates. The current story for cumulative updates, and this is for your existing version of SQL Server. This isn't just SQL Server 2017. Now, if you look at Microsoft's guidance on cumulative updates, they say, hey, we test these a lot. We test these hard, and we think you should test them too. Because with anything, you need to test it, but that they say you should proactively test and regularly apply cumulative updates for your SQL Server instance, which is great because you do want to be proactive and you don't want to be in the position of hitting bugs and then find out that it was released in a cumulative update released months ago. So Microsoft, and this was a year or more ago that they updated things and said, these cumulative updates are well tested and they should be part of your patching cycle. Now the truth is, DBA teams that I've been on, like even back in the SQL Server 2005 days, I remember regularly testing and applying cumulative updates. What we would do is we would go through a testing process using development instances and pre-production instances and have known versions of cumulative updates that had been through the testing cycle before they moved to production. We would not move every cumulative update into production just because the amount of testing that we put them through, but we would frequently move to, okay, we've gone through and tested through this version of the cumulative update and it is safe for us. At times, I mean, we would review every cumulative update that came out and at times would see mention of issues in there, which we were like, okay, we should get this into the testing cycle quickly because it sounded like something we'd really want to avoid, but we wouldn't necessarily deploy every version of cumulative update. What you choose to do, the frequency that you choose to test and deploy cumulative updates is totally up to you, but Microsoft really encourages you to not wait for service packs on your current versions of SQL Server before you apply changes, because they do fix big changes here. And part of the reason that I won't miss service packs is for these current versions of SQL Server where we have cumulative updates and service packs, you can get into weird positions with them because they are slightly different, and sometimes a bug can be detected and fixed in a cumulative update that then doesn't end up in the service pack based on timing. You can actually, I don't know if you've ever been in the situation where you're sort of stuck between a cumulative update and a service pack, but we've had a couple of instances where, you know, something, a bug was confirmed by Microsoft and it wasn't confirmed in time to make the like service pack release train, but it did make a cumulative update release train. And so you'd get into this situation where if you installed the service pack, you weren't protected from the bug. If you installed the cumulative update technically lower than the service pack, you'd be protected from the bug. So you'd have the choice of, do I go with the cumulative update and then wait for the service pack? But then, oh wait, maybe my change approver is biased towards service packs and they don't like cumulative updates, so then I'll be vulnerable to this bug. And what would happen in those situations is usually Microsoft would shortly release a hotfix or a patch to the service pack if the bug was important enough so that you'd kind of get out of the situation. But it was just weird and awkward. And when we think about this, if we're really testing cumulative updates super hard, like what is the point of service packs? Service packs, like if cumulative updates are thoroughly tested, and for SQL Server 2017, there's a great blog post on the release services site where they talk about things like, yes, they are going to be fully localized for the cumulative updates. If these are thoroughly tested to the level that service packs are, well, what's the point of having service packs at all? There are some things that had to be changed, like the rules about the servicing lifecycle for Microsoft, like how old can your SQL Server instance get and still be supported by Microsoft, questions like that. Those rules had to do with like, okay, how long was the latest service pack, you know, released ago? So those have been updated for SQL Server 2017. They've been updated to refer to the cumulative update lifecycle now. So there still is a support lifecycle. It's shifting to be specific to the cumulative updates. And I really think this just makes for a simpler world where cumulative updates are rigorously tested, which they should be, because we're encouraged to, right, test and implement them. I personally won't miss service packs. Now, this will for those change approvers, for folks who've been around in IT for a while and are like wary, who are like, we don't move to a version of SQL Server until SP1 is out. Well, for those folks, you need to kind of figure out, well, okay, what's the equivalent to you? If we don't technically have a service pack, is 6 months of cumulative updates good enough? Because there is, Microsoft has announced, okay, for 2017, we aren't going to have service packs. We are going to release cumulative updates on a given schedule. We're going to do it once a month, I think, for the first year, and they even give like a date for it. And then after that, it goes through a different cycle. So you can, you know, at the 6 month point, we should have 6 cumulative updates. So at what point do they feel comfortable? These days, things are really changing. And I think there's even more to think about rather than just general availability for the boxed product. There's also, I mean, for SQL Server 2017, many of the features were available in Azure SQL Database before we had general availability of the box product. So do you start the 6 months from the point at which people could raise their compat level in Azure SQL Database? I think it's really up to you. I do think that it's good for everyone if we start phasing this into our environments early. And one way to think about this, if you have multiple SQL servers, is, of course, phasing it in on our development instances and our least critical production instances first, getting really comfortable with it, and then going on our more critical instances later. depending on how you do your licensing, what your options are, things will vary, of course. But I do think, yes, there is the change approver who has to adjust if there aren't any service packs. Let's reconsider when we deploy. But I honestly think that's a good thing because I don't believe in waiting for service pack one personally to deploy. Yeah, whenever we're changing things, we can run into issues, but we also get lots of cool, interesting new features as well as performance enhancements. So now is a good time to review your patching and your upgrade process. And I think it's a celebration to enjoy the fact that service packs won't always be part of our world and that with the life cycle of SQL Server 2017, we can say goodbye to service packs. Thanks so much for joining me for Dear SQL DBA. And shout out to all of you who've left a review for Dear SQL DBA on iTunes. Your star ratings and your reviews really, really help the podcast. I very much appreciate it. And also for folks who've left reviews on the free courses at SQLWorkbooks.com, thank you folks so much. That really helps me build the business and it really helps me continue. So please consider leaving me a review either on SQLWorkbooks.com or for the podcast on iTunes. Thanks so much, folks, and I'll see you next week.